place to hand them to me here. I'm gonna start cooking them over there. Oh, our garnish. Aloha. Pina. I actually got this idea in Puerto Rico. We did a half-out grilled pineapple. What we do on the inside, we make a pineapple champagne with all the dressing. So on the pan top, all I'm gonna do is mark it for a little color. Just take a saute pan, a little extra virgin olive oil, and let that get hot. Little baby face scallops and baby shrimp and some garlic. We're gonna saute that up for you. Let this get hot. Luke is gonna start sauteing that. And then do some yellow squash, zucchini, and red pepper. So this is action packed. Let it cook down. I was just with Guillo Beach, Puerto Rico, a little restaurant. Where the kiosks, are, you know where that is? My cousin Marita, she's like, oh, you gotta go check out this guy's restaurant right on the beach. I'm like, okay, cool, I'll check it out. The guy comes out with this pineapple. He didn't have shrimp and scallops, he had something else besides. But the presentation I thought was so cool. I said, oh, I gotta bring this home to Chicago. People will never believe it. So this is gonna be like a little mix between Puerto Rican and Mexican. So what I'm gonna do now, the Mexican part is, I'm gonna put some chipotle ketchup that we make. Chipotle ketchup. See here in the kitchen, you know, everything, if somebody moves something out of place, it's like, it slows down your rhythm. That should have been over there. So I'm putting some little chipotle paste. I'm gonna add some fine diced veggies, yellow squash, zucchini, and red pepper. I'm gonna saute this up. It's all cooking down. And now the fun begins. Pick a little rice, okay, with our own sofrito. Here comes the Puerto Rican part, right? Leche de coco. Kind of like the focus on our restaurant is mixing Mexican and Puerto Rican flavors together. Too hot, right? Lots of flavor. Getting that sweet, the savory, the spice, shrimp, the scallop. You can do this with salmon, you can do this with chicken. It's kind of like a mini fast paella, really, without the help of chicken. Really nice. Thickening up, we're using that coconut together, that sweetness. Starting to thicken. You got your piña, you're a fire. A little garnet and a fork, and you're done.
Yes.
A little tomato. A little, this is cilantro oil that we mixed. A little mango puree. What I like to do is, I like edible garnish. Edible garnish. Instead of having a stick of rosemary, I'd rather give you some interesting flavors of things that you can eat. Why not? Finish it off with a little lemon, lime, and cilantro. And there you have it. Pina de la playa.